so today is faculty concert for music major seminar. And we want to just, even though you have the program, or some of you, or you got it in an email, we're going to tell you a little bit about the piece that we're playing, because it's very special. There's a slight change in the program, but we'll just all be announcing what we're playing, so you'll have an, we won't keep you in the dark. Okay, and you guys have a student recital coming up in a few weeks, so please think about your selections and get them to your teachers. Okay, I'm going to hand the mic over to Julia.
So we'll start with a trio by Germaine Taillefer, and this was written in the late 1800s, and she was one of a group called the Six in France, a group of composers. She was the only female, but a group of composers who talked musical ideas, who kind of helped to shape musical ideas in that country. Notably, it did not include perhaps the most famous lasting composers, Debussy and Ravel. But these six included her, and she wrote this trio in four movements, so we'll play it straight through four movements. And she had an interesting and, by all accounts, rather difficult life. I mean, first of all, because she was a female composer and musician at that time. But second of all, she was not supported by her family. Her father did not want her to be a musician and didn't support that idea for her. And it wasn't until she started winning awards and doing quite well at the Paris Conservatory that that he kind of accepted that, okay. But in fact, she changed her name because there was such a rift over this, and she felt so unsupported. So it's kind of remarkable. She ended up coming to New York, and she reworked this herself quite late in her life. And I think just from a performance standpoint and a musical standpoint, it's interesting. We're so used to having all sorts of resources and references, recordings and scores and multiple editions and things being reworked for us. This edition is full of inconsistencies, and so it's been kind of a fun puzzle, an ongoing puzzle, to figure out what to take from the score, what to change. Are the notes wrong, or are they just very dissonant? So it's been kind of an interesting journey for us, and it's because this composer has been not performed a whole lot, so we're really excited to play this work in four movements for you.
Thank you. start on vegan at a later date, but we will, and it's really awesome. So we're going to be doing some bobcat brass for you.
As we reset the stage, we are Bobcat Brass, the brass faculty at the School of Music. And as Dr. Little said, we're going to be playing three selections for you today, starting off with a commission that we commissioned from a Guadeloupean young composer named Alyssa Regent, who worked with us to write a piece called Spindle, Shuttle, and Needle. We premiered this last summer at the International Women's Brass Conference, and we're super excited to bring it here today. And I'd love to read you the program notes that Alyssa has sent to us, and a quote from the fairy tale that this piece is based on. So it's a short 3-minute piece called Spindle, Shuttle, and Needle. And Spindle, Shuttle, and Needle is based from the fairy tale of the same name written by Brothers Grimm. More specifically, I was inspired, this is Alyssa speaking, from the spinning wheel, which is at the heart of the metaphor of the story. It tells the tale of a young maiden's enchanted spinning wheel that has come alive and weaved love into her life. In this piece, I was fascinated by the image of the single thread of fabric being weaved in and out and creating a new reality, guiding the music in and out of harmony and texture, creating new worlds while unweaving older ones.
Thank you. piece we're going to do is a selection from a multi-movement work. We're going to do the first movement from a piece called Scenes from the Bayou by Gina Gilley. She's a composer and a professor at Pacific Lutheran. And this piece was commissioned by Black Bayou Brass in the University of Louisiana. And so the movement we're going to play is called Morning on the Bayou. It's the first movement, appropriately, because it depicts the scenes from, how many been, raise your hand, how many been to the South? Louisiana? Anywhere? Hot and humid? Good. Okay. So you can kind of imagine, this is the depicting the scenes when the animals are waking up. You got alligators just starting to roam, and then you have that fog on and that mist on top of the water. And you can just kind of, like, you could slice a knife through the humidity, and it's really hot. But those are the scenes that this piece and movement is depicting. So see if you can hear that in these sounds. So Gina Gilley, Scenes from the Bayou, Morning on the Bayou.
Thank you.
So this next piece is one of our favorites. We did this at the IWBC conference last May. It's entitled Trio for Brass. It's in three movements by Václav Nelibel, who is a American Czech, or I should say Czech-American composer. He immigrated to the United States in the 50s and had his career here as a composer and a professor of composition for many, many years till he died in the 90s. Is that what you said?
97. Yeah.
97. Nelibel has written lots and lots and lots and lots of wonderful brass music. We are very indebted to him for growing the repertoire of instruments that don't have, as trombone, you know, 400 concertos and sonatas from the Romantic period, or the Classical period, or the Baroque period. Or so he wrote lots and lots of brass music, and we found this piece. It was actually originally scored for two trumpets and trombone, but it sounds even better with a horn in the middle. So this is a Trio for Brass by Václav Nelibel. Thank you.